There are three different types of north. They are the true, the grid, and magnetic north. Grid north is a navigational phrase used to refer to the northward on a grid lines in a map projection. Grid north contrasts the true north and the magnetic north in that it is aligned to grid lines and always points upward on a map. True north or geodetic north refers to the direction along the surface of the earth as you proceed towards geographic north pole. Earth's rotational axis at north pole is the direction the true north points to. The magnetic north refers to the direction a compass needle will point corresponding to the magnetic field lines of the earth. The pole may not be the exact point since the compass aligns itself to the local geomagnetic field which varies constantly. The three norths are important to map readers and navigators in making them understand topography. The difference between magnetic north and true north is the angle of inclination on a horizontal plane, mostly referred to as magnetic variation or declination. The angular difference between true north and grid north on a horizontal plane is known as convergence angle or grid convergence. The relative direction of true, grid, and magnetic north will depend entirely on where on earth you are and where on map projection you are. Here are a few examples. You can see how the magnetic variation and convergence angle changes with the changing latitude. Let's now see a practical example. You want to fly from Muscat to Mumbai and you have been given a heading of 100 degree to follow. You don't know if the heading given to you is with reference to grid or true north. And you could very well end up in Goa in place of Mumbai. Always be sure about your heading or you may end up in wrong place. Say you are in grid zone 42 in northern hemisphere. Suppose your boat is west of central meridian and your grid heading is always greater than the true heading. And if you are east of central meridian, then your true heading is always greater than grid heading. So remember, in northern hemisphere, east of central meridian, positive convergence, and west of central meridian is negative convergence. And if you are in southern hemisphere, your grid heading is always greater than your true heading when you are east of central meridian. And in west of central meridian, your grid heading will be less than true heading. So in southern hemisphere, east of central meridian is negative convergence and west of central meridian is positive convergence. If you happen to see a nautical chart, it will always contain something called a compass rose, which will have info regarding magnetic variation in that particular position. But no chart will give you information about grid convergence or convergence angle. It is because the ships and vessels use gyro compass and they always gives you heading of the vessel from true north. Vessels also carry magnetic compass in case of emergency situation where you cannot use gyro compass. But a nautical chart may include the value of convergence angle somewhere in the description. Same is the case for aeroplanes. They use gyro as well as magnetic compass. But for us surveyors, we need to know the true as well as grid heading. So knowing convergence angle is very essential for us. If you want to know more about convergence angle and how to calculate them, please see one of my previous videos, link in the description. Thank you for being here with me.